The Philippine Supreme Court held its first online presser today, led by Chief Justice Diosdado Peralta himself. ABS-CBN's Mike Navallo is on the line to give us details. Mike, good afternoon.
Hi, Rica. ABS-CBN Corporation will have to wait at least 1 month more before the Supreme Court could act on its plea to resume broadcast operations. Chief Justice Diosdado Peralta revealed this in a press conference this morning that the High Court will tackle ABS-CBN's petition on July 13, a date chosen by the justice in charge of the petition. Peralta said it is not clear if a resolution will already be ready by then and if magistrates can agree on the outcome. He said they had to wait for all comments from all parties to come in, but he declined to comment on what's keeping the Supreme Court from acting an urgent plea. ABS-CBN had said it loses 30 to 35 million pesos in advertising revenues for every day it is off the air, endangering the jobs of its 11,000 workers. In the same press conference, Peralta disclosed a separate petition filed by lawyer Paris Rial, seeking to bring ABS-CBN back on the airwaves, which will be discussed on Tuesday. Peralta, meanwhile, explained the delay in resolving a petition asking for the release of sick and elderly detainees filed by more than 20 political prisoners. He said the justice in charge is still in the Visayas due to the flight ban and could not participate in the deliberations due to technical problems. The Chief Justice noted the difficulty of discussing without the justice in charge physically present during deliberations. But he said that on Tuesday, they will proceed to discuss the petition even through video conferencing. This morning's press conference is the first ever conducted online and is in line with efforts to go digital, prompted by the coronavirus pandemic. He said they are discussing issues surrounding video conferencing during hearings, particularly in criminal cases. He also bared the Supreme Court has hired an IT expert to address technological concerns. Addressing COVID-19 concerns, Peralta said there were about two or three Supreme Court employees who underwent rapid tests who tested positive for the coronavirus but were eventually cleared upon confirmation. All Supreme Court employees are subjected to three mandatory rapid tests, but not those from the courts nationwide. The Chief Justice said he advised judges to proceed to the Supreme Court to undergo rapid testing. Peralta declined to comment on the supposed double standard of implementing quarantine protocols and on the question of whether there's legal basis for prohibition on rallies, but he did comment on the anti-terrorism bill, saying anyone affected by the new law, once signed by the president, can question its constitutionality. Rica?
Thank you so much, Mike Navallo.